If your new person don't know, is it really a friendship?
If your new person
does, if your new person does not know that you're still cool with your ex, is it really a friendship? And what are you trying to hide? Because the only reason why you would stay in contact with your ex is either pride or ego. Pride or ego is the only reason. Because if you're done, if you're really done, mm-hmm. and you say you're over it, because you can't, again, you can't heal while somebody's in your space. Right, so you can stay, you can find out what they're doing, and you can monitor them. But this is the thing, Jarrell. I'm going to take it another step. This is how you know you're really done with your ex. How you really know you're done is when you delete that text message. Because that text message that you have of them has every message, photo, nasty thought, dream you had.
Picture.
Whenever you slide that thing over, and if you
the
have an
thread.
iPhone.
You're talking about the whole thread.
When you slide that thing over, like this is how you do it with an iPhone. I don't know how you do it with a Droid. You probably got
the Droid.
Blow it like a Nintendo.
Yeah. Like, they crank it.
Yeah. You got to blow your phone like a Nintendo to get it to take a picture.
Yeah.
You got to warm up. But listen, man, when you delete that thread in your phone.
The whole thread. That's something different.
That's how you know you're done. And people watching right now, you know what I'm talking about. You can say you ain't calling them and all this stuff. But when you delete that thing with all your pictures, because it dates everything. Because you save that thing for your arguments anyway. When you had arguments with your ex, you used to go through, okay, what day we talking about? You said I didn't call you. I called you, and you said you were asleep. Okay.
You type in keywords up top. Keywords up top, yeah.
Man, let me tell you something. But when you delete that thread, that's when you're really done. But I said, only reason why you're keeping in contact with your ex is you're proud of your ego, and you just want to keep tabs on them just so you know you still got a beat on them if you need to check in and, you know, upset them or be like, happy birthday, queen. Happy birthday, gorgeous. Happy New Year to you and yours. Just saying what's up, didn't want anything, just reaching out, hope all is well. I know it's your mother's birthday. I just want to tell moms, you know, I appreciate her being in your life.
You
and her
know,
creating
I love your
you,
mother.
Her creating you, you know, this is she created such a beautiful blessing, just reaching out to say what up. He only doing that to upset your peace. That's it. Delete that thread. If you really done, delete that thread.
Yo, beware of all the, what's up, queen?
With the light-skinned eyes, you know he got, hey, what's good, queen?
Hey, what's up, queen?
I'm out here in the club, and I really don't want to be here, but I'm only here because we didn't make it out. But if you ever want me to come back home, I can. Like, you know what you're doing.
You know. I'm always ready for you.
When you delete that thread, that's when you're really done. Some of y'all right now, you still got that thread lingering. That thing.
Yo.
Oh. And it's probably at the top of your text, too. It's at the top. It ain't at the bottom. It's at the top.
You know, you can save the pictures now. You can
You can. We probably got that thing pinned, too. It's pinned up at the top.
Top five. Like T-Mobile's old top five. We got top five.
Yeah. When you delete that thread, that's how you know you're really done. But people ain't trying to be done. They like the chaos. And it's easier to keep the chaos than actually delete it, feel what you're supposed to feel, and move on and grow. But people don't want to feel what they're supposed to feel. They'd rather blame their ex, even though you call them toxic and you broke up, but you're still saving the text messages. It's easy to blame him.